make yourself at home. But please don't touch anything. This is all vital scientific work. I'll close the door behind you, just a precaution. Sorry, I can't greet you in person. It's safer for both of us, you understand? I'm researching a cure for this terrible infection, you see. It's slow going, as I have so few subjects to test on. Like those poor Omega Group soldiers. Not my finest hour, I fear. If you'll forgive me for a moment, I'm sure you can help me. I say, steady on, old girl. Right. Now here's how you could help. There's a book, De Remedi Secreti, by Konrad Gesner. A fascinating text, but what I'm after is Dee's own copy where he made annotations. I believe it's in the palace library, which means going upstairs, I'm afraid. Would you be so kind? The bunker elevator can take you up to the palace. I hope you don't mind the music, by the way. William Byrd, Elizabeth I's favorite composer, apparently. I find it helps me work, it's very soothing. You're doing ever so well. I do feel awful about the poor guards. Well, technically, I'm an Omega Group myself. Started as an army medic, and then they posted me here. That's such a shame. Those soldiers were an elite. So sad to see them like this. The angel chided me thus. Ignorance was the nakedness whereby you first were tormented, and the first plague that fell upon man was the wanting of science. The want of science hinders you from knowledge of your own self.
I've just realized you probably have no idea what a mega group is. Top secret, you see, but it's an elite group to protect the royal family. But the outbreak caught us on the hop, and now all these poor men who used to guard the bunker, well, I suppose you could say they're still guarding it. If only we'd paid more attention to Dr. D.
Especially in this bloody place. Nice and quiet.
The patient must be restrained and cannot be calmed by any manner of herbal sedative. She seems ravenous, and nothing I feed her can satiate her monstrous appetite, as if compelled by a most foul instinct to devour all life within her reach. She freed herself of her bonds yesterday and would have gutted our horse alive if I had not reached her in time. I find myself in awe of the piteous state to which man is reduced. A walking conduit, a mere empty coil, which lives only to feed its greedy and carnal instincts.
Where was I? You must forgive me, I'm a little distracted. Ah yes, Dr. D. John D was a scientist, alchemist, natural philosopher and all that. To Elizabeth I. Some people say he was even a spy. Imagine that. And Dee wrote a warning, you see, about this outbreak. Oh, dear. Sorry, must dash.
Ah!
Following the recommendations of De Remedi Secreti, I reduced the pus to a dry powder and discovered that injecting the concoction into the subject... God forgive me that I refer to my own wife as subject... causes the black blood to retract and wither. I glimpse the flush of my wife's once rosy complexion through the sickness. Of De Remedi Secreti. I reduced the pus to a dry powder and discovered that injecting the concoction into the subject. God forgive me that I refer. In some subjects, pockets filled with a rich, acrid pus form near hot...
Hello. Oh, I see you found Gesner's book. I do hope it wasn't too much trouble. I pass it through, would you? Ah, wait. There's something else. That gadget of yours looks rather like something the Omega chaps used to carry. Would you step over there and scan that infected chap with it? A full scan and analyze, mind you, to isolate the infected gland. The human body really is a fascinating thing. Even after all vital signs in the subject cease, the body continues to fight the infection. Amazing, eh? I thought so. You'll have to put him out of his misery first. Then take the syringe and fill it up with antibodies from the infected gland. Perfect. Now, that syringe will synthesize a viricide, a sort of poison, quite deadly. There's enough for one injection, but you can refill it from another willing volunteer. In return, I need another favor. A second book, Studium Contagione, the study of infection by Dee himself. It's very rare. But I happen to know Ron Friedman has a copy in his flat on Brick Lane. Ron's one of those raven chaps, you see.
This is where it all started, and this is where it'll end. I promise you. Protect the safe house. Your survival depends on it. Now where are you going? Are you scavenging for supplies or what? The pickings round here won't be very rich. These poor buggers have to fend for themselves. Abandoned by the government, the so-called public servants, who all hot-footed it to Westminster and the palace instead. That lot of good it did them, eh? You hear that? That's exactly why this country's gone to shite. People partying when they should have been prepping. Honestly, I'm surprised anyone else survived. Okay, maybe not everyone knows about these prophecies, but to be so blind when Armageddon is in your face, I despair.
Ah!
find some way into the room. Looks like you can jump down through a hole in the ceiling. Now we're talking. Double the barrels for double the gun. I've just realised where you are. That's Ron Friedman's place. All you'll find in there is a soft-headed imbecile who turned the Ravens away from the truth. If you're going in, be careful. Ron Friedman is a lying sack of shite. Don't believe a word he says. He'll send you off on some wild goose chase. Ron's flat's on the next floor up. You have to find an air duct and crawl your way upstairs. Yeah. Professor here. Your signal's fading. I'm losing you.
Yeah. This is Sondra to all surviving Ravens. Nest 6, 18, 19, 22, and 34 have been raided by vultures. Situation still evolving. Ron, come in. It's Sondra. Ron, we're coming out in less than 12 hours. Ronald Friedman, if you're ignoring me, I swear. Answer me, for God's sake, Ron!
Prepper here, you read me? Looks like it's heating up in there. Find the kitchen and use the rubbish chute. It's your quickest way out.
Thank you. Dear John, I'll never forget everything you've given me. Our time together was the happiest of my life. But now those memories are tarnished. And I want it to stop. We both know that you don't belong to us.
Thank you.
You found Dee's Studium Contagione. Oh, this will be invaluable. If only I had been quick enough to save them. I tried, I did. And I made progress. But what survives, well, one can't call it life. I'm almost glad my Omega Group colleagues never lived to see the day. This is Dee's last letter to Francis Bacon. Dear Francis, and so on and so forth. Yes, he mentions the Panacea Code. Now, the Ravens believe they possess this code, and they must still be in London somewhere. I don't know how, but if you can track them down and retrieve this code, it could unlock a cure. Meanwhile, I must soldier on. I swore an oath to my queen and my vocation to shed light upon the dark corners of ignorance, and so I must. See yourself out.
There you are. What were you doing back in the palace? Look, never mind. I've had an idea. There are reports of a military camp at the palace. The guy in charge is Colonel Waverley, my old CO in Desert Storm. So tell him the Prepper sent you. He'll see you right. You could do with some better weapons, and a bit of C4 wouldn't go amiss.